Amen. So I like to share how I get the messages, and this message, it just kind of hit me. I had a real amazing experience with Deliverance several weeks ago, and I'll share that story as we get more into the message. But then I was thinking about the dynamic, and I'll touch on it a little bit. I was in a service. Thank you, Lord. I was in a service at a local church, and it was towards the end of the service. And I was sitting there, and I was getting a little sleepy. I'll be honest. I was getting a little sleepy. And I was kind of, it wasn't the preacher. It was me. It was me. It was my fault. And I was just kind of a little sleepy. And so my wife's doing, you know, kind of, hey, wake up. You know, I'm like, because you know it's obvious. You got the head bob. You know, it's pretty obvious. So, and then I hear this noise. And it's coming from the hallway. I hear this noise. And I kind of, you know, okay. And then I hear it again. And I'm like, okay, what? Oh, the worship band. They must just be about coming back out. You know, maybe they're getting, no, that's not. Is that a baby crying? No. That sounds like Deliverance. So it keeps going. And I'm like, say, hey. Kind of nudge my wife. I mean, you hear that out there? Sounds like Deliverance. So I was like, okay. Well, it kept going, and it was pretty loud, and it was a pretty big church, but you could hear it. And they were about to do the prayer and open the altar, and so I would kind of already checked out of the message, to be honest with you, and I was just kind of, you know, I was in my own little zone, and I was, okay, I feel I can help. I'm going to go help. And I got up, and I walked outside, and I walked out the door to help. Amen? I guess I've been spoiled by the Deliverance Center. If someone needs freedom...